Hello everyone and welcome to Careers on the Move from Cargomatic. I'm Tyler Kern. Thanks so much for joining us for this episode of the show as we explore careers in the supply chain. And I'm very excited for today's episode because today we're joined by none other than Mr. Supply Chain himself, Daniel Stanton. Daniel, thank you so much for joining us here on the show.
Tyler, thanks for having me.
Well, first and foremost, I got to ask, how do you get to become Mr. Supply Chain? How did you end up with that name?
You know, I just talk about supply chains all the time. I think about supply chains all the time. A few years ago, somebody said, you know, all you ever talk about is supply chains. We ought to just call you Mr. Supply Chain. And it stuck.
It's a pretty great reason. And when someone bestows a nickname on you like that, you just got to take it and run with it, I suppose. So I see your book over your right shoulder there. Tell us a little bit about the book, when you wrote it, what made you decide to write it, that sort of thing.
Sure. So, Tyler, I've been working in supply chain for quite a few years now. And, you know, one of the things we find in supply chain is, you know, even though we've been doing logistics and operations and procurement activities for, you know, as long as we've been doing business, there's a different way of looking at business when you think about it in terms of supply chain. And there's a different language that we use to describe the things that we do in a supply chain. And oftentimes, you know, people don't really get a chance to learn that. Nobody takes the time to explain it well. So when I had the opportunity and I was asked to write Supply Chain Management for Dummies, for me, it was a tremendous opportunity and really a great honor to take all of this rich and rapidly evolving discipline and break it down into, you know, simple explanations that people can use to help frame their careers, you know, choose where they want to go, understand what the opportunities are, and be successful working in the supply chain.
So give us a little background on your history in supply chain and kind of tell us your career path that got you to where you are today, because I think this is particularly interesting and maybe a little bit different than some of the other conversations we've had on the show up to this point.
Sure, absolutely. Well, you know, one of the things that we often joke about in the supply chain is, you know, it's a career of accident, not one of intent, right? So supply chain management, you know, even the term is really pretty new. It's only been around. It was first used about 40 years ago, but it sort of stuck as a way of explaining these interrelationships between procurement and logistics and operations. And what we've started to see, you know, during that 40 years, you know, now we're at the place that there are university degree programs and certifications for supply chain management, but none of that existed, you know, at the time when a lot of the folks that are in management and leadership roles today were starting their careers. So I'm not an exception to that. I stumbled into supply chain sort of by accident. I'd started off studying engineering, went off and I spent some time in the Navy. So I got to travel and be involved in global logistics at sea and in aviation. Then, you know, found that I was pretty good at technology stuff. And I had a bunch of jobs that were IT focused. And then as I moved into management and had to start managing a P&L and you know, managing employees and strategic planning, for me, all of these things connected up. They all seemed like they had interrelationships, but all of them were distinct separate fields. And when I found myself learning about supply chain management, it was the first time in my whole career where I felt like all of these things fit together, right? That you need to understand all the different aspects of the business and the trade-offs that we make when we're making decisions, and the really important role that things like information technology and project management play in helping a business really be profitable and sustainable and meeting its strategic goals.
I really enjoyed listening a little bit more to that history of kind of how you ended up in the industry and where you're kind of gotten to and how you've gotten to where you are today. And I'm curious, just from your perspective, as somebody that maybe has their finger on the pulse of the industry and really stays up to date with things, is supply chain maybe having a moment in terms of, you know, getting into the news a little bit more? It might not always be positive news, but when you have Suez Canal, you know, the freeze here in Texas, lots of other stories where supply chain has kind of become front and center. Is this a time where maybe people are more aware of supply chain and logistics than maybe they have been in the past?
It absolutely, it feels like it's the golden age for supply chain, right? 2020 and 2021. And it started with toilet paper, right? That's the way it's going to go down in the history books. Right. But so much of what you look at that have been headlines in the last 12 months, you know, for toilet paper to groceries, and then, the COVID vaccine distribution, right, became a big story. Then, you know, we've had issues with semiconductor chip shortages and container imbalances. And if there is, you know, one silver lining around all of those very, very dark clouds, it's that everybody now understands we live in a global economy. We're all part of these supply chains, and understanding how to design those, how to manage them, it is really a critical capability, not just for companies, but for their customers, right? And so it isn't just about profitability. It's also really about meeting the needs of your customers and living up to their expectations.
That's the case, maybe, and that people are understanding a little bit more about the impact of supply chain and how important it is these days. Do you think that could have an impact on maybe people's career decisions as far as seeing supply chain and saying, hey, there's an area where I can be involved in what's going on around the world, and maybe an exciting field where there are challenges, where there is problem solving, and you really get to see the nuts and bolts of how things get done. Do you think that can be appealing to maybe a new generation of people?
Absolutely. Absolutely. That's, you know, if you look at the supply chain management profession, you know, we've been struggling for a lot of years with an imbalance between supply and demand of talent. One of the estimates that came out just a couple of years ago was that we have 6 supply chain job openings for every qualified candidate. Just out of control sort of imbalance. And that's a problem for companies, right? If you can't find the people that you need to design and manage your supply chain, you can't grow. You can't be successful as a company. So we already had this demand. We had pent-up demand. That was really driving up salaries, driving recruiting efforts by companies. It was a motivation for universities and online learning providers to create better teaching tools so that folks could access it and pursue those jobs. Now, with, you know, 2020 and 2021, even inside of those companies, the demand has grown even more, right? Now there are more supply chain jobs. There's a lot more hiring. But the good news is, like you say, the workforce is becoming more aware of these opportunities. And so they're taking advantage of training and certification programs. They're taking advantage of university programs. And so it is a golden age for supply chain careers. I'll tell you, you know, there are several groups that I end up talking with a lot about the opportunities in supply chain careers. One of them, naturally, students, right? Folks that are early in their careers trying to figure out what they want to do when they grow up. Lots of different directions that you can go in the supply chain. For all of them, you still need to have this good foundation. You need to understand fundamentally what supply chain management is about, and then you can find the areas that you want to specialize in. So, you know, students obviously are a target. Another group that I do a lot of work with are military veterans, right? Folks that are getting out of the military. Very often, they've got a lot of great experience with procurement, logistics, operations, all the stuff that you need to manage a supply chain. The challenge there is that they use a different language, right? When you're in the military, we have our own jargon, and we have our different ways of doing things. So they need to do is sort of learn the civilian jargon, learn how to frame their experience in a way that'll make sense in a civilian role. But those military folks have great opportunities and end up being very successful in supply chain roles. And then the third group that I spend a lot of time working with are folks that maybe already have had a career and they're a little ways down the road, but for whatever reason, they don't like what they're doing anymore. They're not interested in it. They're not challenged, or, you know, frankly, it's just, it's not a good job. Either they're having a hard time, you know, finding and keeping a role, or it's not paying what they want to be making. And so helping those mid-career folks transition into supply chain management opportunities.
I wonder what kinds of training tools or education or continuing education there is, maybe for people who want to make that switch midstream, that say, look, whatever, you know, what I'm doing right now, either not fulfilling, like you mentioned, not paying enough, not the job I want, that sort of thing. For people that want to make that career transition, are there tools and educational elements that can help them make that switch over and find a career in supply chain that really suits what their skills are?
Absolutely. So Exhibit A, right? Supply Chain Management for Dummies, you know, the way that the book is structured is about the first 80% of the book is explaining what supply chains are, you know, going over the language, the processes, the different kinds of technology that we use. But at the end of the book, the last two chapters are all about supply chain careers and about supply chain education and certification options. So that is literally, you know, where the book wraps up is, if you found some stuff in here that made sense and that you want to pursue, here's how to find those jobs. Here are some of the training programs and certifications that would be useful for that. So that's one resource. I'll put that up as Exhibit A. The second one is, I've got a course up on LinkedIn Learning. I've got two courses actually that are really useful for this. One of them is, I think the title is Careers in Supply Chain and Operations, where I walk through, I don't know, probably 20 different kinds of job roles. And explain what's involved in each one to just sort of give folks an idea of, oh, yeah, that's something I could do, or that's something I could do. And, you know, with the recognition that a lot of the stuff that's there may not be interesting. That's not the point, right? The point is, well, what are the things that actually would be a fit with what I like to do, what I have for experience, what I want to be doing with my life? So that supply chain careers course is a good one. And then for folks that have a direction they want to move in and have a plan, I've got a second course called Supply Chain Certification Tips and Tricks, which talks about how to get the credentials that you need to go after whatever job you've chosen. So those two courses on LinkedIn Learning are a pretty good double whammy. There is also, I'll mention, a whole learning path on LinkedIn Learning of about 13 courses, so that you can get it's almost 20 hours worth of training in supply chain management, and you get a certificate saying you completed the Become a Supply Chain Manager learning path that you can put on your LinkedIn profile, you can put on your resume. If anybody's interested in that, I've set up a website to make it easy to find all of those things. If you go to supplychainvideos.com, there are direct links to each of those courses and the learning paths to make it easy.
supplychainvideos.com. So yeah, head there for more information on what Daniel was just describing. But I think when I think about supply chain, I think about the fact that there are so many different career avenues into supply chain and so many different areas that I almost hesitate to ask this question. But when you think of the skills maybe that make somebody ideally suited to work in supply chain, what skills do you think maybe set someone up well to have a career in supply chain? Skills, abilities, soft skills, those sorts of things. What stands out to you as making someone an ideal candidate for a role in supply chain?
Well, you know, Tyler, it depends, right? It all depends on, you know, what sort of, and I would go at it the other way and say, you know, first you have to start and figure out, well, what are the things that you're good at and that you like to do? There's a job for that, right? And so it's really a question, I think, of working your way into it. For example, there are lots of jobs in supply chain analytics for people that like analyzing numbers and solving problems. There are lots of jobs in project management, right? For folks who like coming up with a plan, bringing a team together, tracking progress. A ton of jobs in supply chain automation for folks that, you know, are really tuned into IT stuff, robotics, engineering, control systems. That's, you know, there are places for all of that within supply chain roles. And what one of the things that I really love about working in the supply chain industry, the supply chain community, is that you can take those skills and experience that you use in one role for, you know, maybe a few years, and you can switch into a completely different role, and that stuff is still useful. It's still valuable, and it can help you either move horizontally or advance in your career and be more successful as you progress. So, quick examples, right? I've known folks who've gone from being associates in a warehouse to being supply chain vice presidents, right? Where they're overseeing transportation and manufacturing logistics. And all of that experience that they had being on the floor, learning what works and what doesn't when it comes to managing inventory and motivating people and safety issues, right? Having that grounded hands-on experience actually helped them become effective senior leaders years later.
I think it's a great point. Yeah, absolutely. And just fantastic advice. Now, I want to circle back because you said one of the other groups of people that you talk to quite a bit are college students, right? So if you have one piece of advice for college students who are thinking about a role in supply chain, what kind of advice would you give them and what would you be sharing with them?
So, you know, one of the pieces of probably unconventional advice that I would share is look for hard jobs. Don't look for an easy job. Don't try to skate your way through earlier in your career. Because what I find is the more difficult, the more challenging the assignments that people take on earlier in their career, the more that they learn, the more experience they get in the same amount of time, right? Because experience isn't just a measure of years or months. Experience is a measure of things that you got to do and things that you got done. And so the more that you can pack in earlier on, the more you're going to learn about yourself, the more you're going to learn about the opportunities that are out there, and the better candidate, the more attractive you're going to be when you're competing for those other roles later on in your career.
I think that's absolutely fantastic advice and something that that maybe all of us should take to heart on some level, is just challenging ourselves in new and unique ways. And, you know, one of the things that I think that stands out about supply chain to me as I think about younger generations and college students today, you know, looking at a role in supply chain, is that I think people want to know, what impact am I having? What am I doing at my job that advances something else or changes the world in some way? And I think that just with all of the stories we've seen and the things that we were mentioning off the top, be it the toilet paper shortage at the beginning of the pandemic, to the rollout of the vaccine, to the Suez Canal, to freezing in Texas and all of these sorts of things, is that roles in supply chain do have a very tangible, you do make a very tangible difference in the world. And I think that it is something that young people are looking for these days, and something that really stands out about supply chain is you can see a very tangible effect of what your job is doing in terms of what's happening around the world and global trade and all of these sorts of things. And to me anyways, that would be a big selling point.
I'd take it a step further and say anything that you are passionate about, anything that you think would make the world a better place, depends on supply chain management for it to be successful. If you're thinking about sustainability, if you're thinking about human rights, if you're thinking about global health and poverty and making sure that, you know, we're helping people access nutrition, helping people access information and education, accessing healthcare, all of those things depend on supply chain management to be effective.
Man, I think that's a really powerful statement, a really powerful way to begin to wrap up this episode. So as we begin to wrap up, I want to cast an eye forward on maybe some of the big topics and the big trends coming down the pike in supply chain here over the next several years. So as being Mr. Supply Chain, what are some of the big trends that you see coming down the line, whether it is technology or different ways of thinking? What stands out to you and what does the future look like for supply chain?
So there is so much, Tyler. It's hard to even know where to start. But I'll give an example. I'll pick three things. And I'll say, you know, if you really think about those three things and how they're changing supply chain, it's hard to not believe that the world is going to be different in 5 to 10 years. And so the first one is electric vehicles, right? So we see that we're in the middle of this transition from internal combustion engines to electric vehicles. And you know, a big part of the reason that we need to make that transition is for sustainability reasons. Well, if you look at where those carbon emissions come from, so much of it is from the supply chain. And if you look at, you know, what's changed in the last year, one of the big changes is a lot more last mile delivery, right? And so the supply chain is really contributing to this problem of carbon. At the same time that we're trying to be responsive to customer needs, the only way that that's going to make sense is if we transition from internal combustion to electric vehicles. So I think that emerging technology could really, really change supply chains a lot more than, you know, it will sort of day-to-day life and the cars that we have in our driveway. That's one. The second one is artificial intelligence, right? And so, you know, if you think about automating the decisions that are made in a supply chain for planning and execution, if you think about, you know, taking those electric vehicles and making them autonomous so they can drive themselves, or you think about, you know, drones that are able to pick things up and drop them off, that's all artificial intelligence. So I see, you know, really a lot of the things that are happening in supply chains, a lot of the decisions and the actions moving away from people and to technology. Doesn't mean there won't be jobs for supply chain people. It just means that we need to be really comfortable with the technology because we're going to be driving those decisions and automating the processes. The third one that I'd say is robotics, right? So if you actually follow an order when you buy something from the grocery store or online and work it backward, it gets handled by a lot of people, right? You know, from the factory to the packaging to the shipping and putting it in distribution centers and warehouses and loading it on trucks. Right now, a lot of that is done by human beings. And we have new robotic technologies that have been emerging and are really breaking through now that can just do that better than people. Right, that's a technology. The robotics for transportation and warehousing are just really, really kind of on that hockey stick. So if you combine those three, right, this transition to electric vehicles, automation and artificial intelligence, and robotics and I'll just say robotics for transportation and warehousing. It's hard to imagine that in 5 to 10 years, supply chains aren't going to look a whole lot different, right, than they do today. So I think there's a lot of really exciting stuff on the technology side. That to me is just really exciting as, you know, a part of the supply chain community.
It sounds like an extremely exciting time to be a part of this industry, to be considering being a part of this industry. And so I think that what you laid out here today should motivate plenty of people to take a look at supply chain and to see, hey, does this work for me? Is this the right decision for me? Daniel, if people want more information on you, on the content you're creating and the things you're doing these days, where can people go?
Website, of course, danielstanton.com. I'm most active on LinkedIn, share stuff there all the time. I've got a weekly LinkedIn newsletter. I'm on Twitter. And then, of course, you know, the Supply Chain Management for Dummies and my LinkedIn learning courses are really there to help people learn about supply chain careers and to be successful in their career journeys.
Excellent, excellent stuff. You can find him on LinkedIn. Go to his website, danielstanton.com. Everyone, thank you so much for joining us for this episode. Daniel, thank you so much for being our guest here on this episode of Careers on the Move.
It was fun. Thanks, Tyler.
And everyone, thank you for tuning in to another episode of Careers on the Move from Cargomatic. We appreciate it very much. Stay tuned for more episodes. We'll be back very, very soon. But for my guest today, Mr. Supply Chain himself, Daniel Stanton, I've been your host, Tyler Kern. Thanks for watching.